let me complete this. It's an easier one, okay? And also, this is your last topic in your module 2, okay? Can I start?
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, last time final out, sir.
Huh?
Should we switch on the camera, sir?
For what?
For internal, sir.
Yeah, yeah. You alone, what is your name?
Sagar, sir.
Sagar.
Sagar alone.
Sagar alone, you have to switch on the camera, okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir. Background is enough, no, sir. Only background.
Front of you and right, sir.
No, no. Your face and your paper should be clearly visible for the entire class. Only one person will be watched for the entire class.
Please, sir. Follow that problem, sir.
Huh?
Vishma will write with Nanjo's eye, sir.
Sagar, I'm going to kick you, Sagar. Enough.
Hey, Nanjo's eye, Bill, feel bad, okay?
Hey. Why are you pulling in the Nandu sir? What is doing that? He is simply keeping quiet. Sagar.
No, sir. He is texting, sir.
Sir,
to say
Sagar
that.
Sagar is like that only, sir.
He is texting in group, sir,
to send that.
That's why we are asking you, sir.
Okay.
Nandu sir is asking us to ask you, sir.
Okay. So you are having fun during IOT classes. Enjoy. Okay, guys. Continue. Yeah. Okay, guys, so let me finish this up. This 20-minute lecture. Today's topic is data analytics. As I told you, numerous amount of data is being generated from the sensor. It has to be analyzed properly. So how to analyze this is we have certain steps to do it. Okay. So what you should know, what is data analytics? First, it is nothing but it is a process of examining the particular data and pre-processing the actual data and then cleansing the data and exploring the data and creating a model from this data. Okay, this is an important interview question whenever you face your final interview. So I'm repeating this. It is the process of examining, pre-processing, cleansing, exploring and creating a model from the data. This is, we call it as the data analytics. To give a pictorial representation, I have plotted this diagram. I didn't get the exact output of this model. This makes you understand what is how our data analytics works. Okay. See, at the first stage, let's keep this as the streaming data. I'm keeping this as a streaming data. That is the data collected from the sensors. For example, let's keep this first column as the temperature data, this one as the pressure data, and then this one maybe as the moisture data. See here, whatever the data is collected from the sensor, it is kept as it is. So next level is I'm going to process this data. What is the kind of a processing I've done here? See here, I created a table here, okay, like with rows and columns. So this first row specifies the value of a particular device. The second row specifies the value of the second device. Third row specifies the value of the third device. So some kind of a processing I've done here, right? So that is your second step, some kind of a makeup from this initial level. Okay. The third level is cleansing the data or cleaning the data. What is this here? If you take the second record, the values completed, the collected from the device 2, it doesn't have this pressure data. So this data should not be taken into this IoT infra for further processing, because at the end, this simple invalid value or the missing value will create a huge impact on your entire process. So it is our necessity to remove this value. So see here, I have cleansed the value. From this, I have removed this entire data record. As I told you, it will not be removed permanently. It will be stored in the particular cache. Then, whichever has got the complete values, I have moved to the next level. Then with this, I am doing some exploratory data analysis using some algorithms. After this, I am getting this chart. Then, what is this exploratory data analysis? I am doing some analysis. That is, out of these data, which of the data plays a major role for my business? Which are all the important data which may have a high impact in my IoT solution? That I'm doing this using various algorithms. Okay. Finally, with this data, with this intelligent data, I'm producing this model. Here, I didn't get the exact output. Here, this model specifies the exact solution, and outside we have this outliers. Okay, I'll say what is an outlier. So am I clear, guys? Did you get an overview? So first step is streaming, second one is processing, cleansing, exploring, and creating a model out of it. Okay. So what is first step? As I told you, examining of data. So I'm calling it as the inspection. So what kind of an examination we are going to do here, or an inspection is done is, here we'll be examining that particular data from the sensor, and we will be trying to allocate it to a schema. So schema is like, what is schema? You know, right? It contains tables. It contains rows and columns. Some kind of a structure we are going to give. Okay. So why should we do this? Examine this data, because whenever the data is flowsim, no, its definition is very, very important. What is definition is that details like where the data is coming from. What is its type? Type means, is it a temperature data? Is it a moisture data? And what is its range? Range may be like, see here, it ranges between 5.67, 5.2.17. So this is your range. Okay. So for this, you have to do this examining process to understand these things. That is definition part. Some more things is, what else can be done is, based on this definition part, a further solution can be designed, and further implementation could be taken through. Okay. Now, so far you have identified the definition part, like type, its range, its frequency. So whenever the new data comes in, it will automatically be connected with these keywords. Like whenever the new data or raw data flows in, it will be connected with these three keywords, like type, range, and frequency. So it will be checked with these keywords. Okay. So overall, we conclude in this way. It is nothing but identification of the structure of a data and trying to combine the same with the definition. That is, combines means checking it with the original structure. Okay, this we call it as the examination. Next one is processing of data. Okay, as I told you, the initial data is unstructured, but when you take it to the cloud, cloud has its internal capability to make it as a semi-structured data. Okay. Or it will, if you use a good algorithm, it can even completely change this unstructured data to a structured data. But as of now, what it is an unstructured data. Okay. So to convert this unstructured data, we are using a schema. As I told you, we converted this into rows and columns. Okay. What else can be done during this processing stages? It can be transformed to a particular form. Okay. Using these schemas. Okay, then from this you can move further to the implementation part. Okay, but before moving into this implementation part, cleansing is very, very important. Okay, so what is this cleansing part? Okay, cleansing is nothing but deduction and removing your inconsistent, incorrect, or inaccurate values. Again, this is an important question they will be asking. What is cleansing in data analytics? It's nothing but detection and removal of your inconsistent, incorrect, and inaccurate values from your data. Okay, this three we call it as the outlier. Okay, so whenever you're working with any IoT project, you will be expecting a 5% outlier. These 5% outlier, the ratio may be very less, but it should be given a more importance, and it should be removed from the particular project or the product. Okay. So utmost care should be given to the outlier. Okay. So how does this outlier varies? Is it may vary based on the particular project you are working with, like the scenario you are working with and the source of the data. Okay. So whichever the scenario may be, the outlier should be removed. Okay. So the next stage is, after removing it, we can go with the further analysis. Okay. So let me give a practical example for it. Okay. If you take any e-marketing website like Amazon and Flipkart, whichever you're using, no? So whenever you log in, your history is maintained by that algorithm inside the algorithm they have written for their own website. Okay, so what this algorithm does is it will maintain the history of your browsing, like how many minutes you have spent inside this website and what is the product you are working you are fondly looking into. Okay, how much product you are related with, like if you choose a bread, sorry, if you have selected a watch now, the next item you might have selected a pen, like that, they will search the nearby products. Okay, so entire journey will be recorded. Okay, so for example, let's keep for this month, you have browsed Amazon websites for 6 times. Okay, so the first 4 times you have done like this. But in the 5th and 6th time, what you have done, no? In the 5th time, you have logged in using your different phone number, maybe your friend's phone number or your dad's phone number and your mom's phone number. Okay, you have directly used some other number and you have purchased that product. You didn't spend much of time in that website and you have left. This we call it as the outlier. I hope I'm clear. Can I repeat one more example I give? See, what is an example for outlier? Similarly, if you take the website, in the 6th time, what you have done is, in the 4th time, you have placed a product in your cart so that you thought that was important. Maybe you can purchase it later. As of at that time, you didn't have much money to buy it. Maybe for the future, you have kept it in your cart. Okay, for the 6th time, you log in suddenly and you buy that product and you immediately come out. Okay, you didn't spend much of time in the website. So this is also an outlier. Okay, so these two histories, no, it should not be maintained with your database because it creates a confusion whenever the browsing is done. Okay, so this kind of data, so everything I have put it as a theory, so this kind of a data should be removed from your thing. So this we call it as the cleansing. Yeah, am I clear, guys? Yes. Did you get an overview? Yes. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. What is cleansing? Did you get? I've used this Amazon and Flipkart website. What is cleansing? Okay. So this much important history is being removed from your database. That is cleansing. Okay. Next level is exploring your data. Okay. After performing this cleansing process, we have to find the insights from the data. That is intelligence inside this data. Okay. How to do this is we can use any statistical methods. Okay, what kind of statistical methods it can be used is, there are two varieties. One is your univariate method, second one is your bivariate methods. So univariate method, you might be familiar with mean, median, mode or histograms. Okay, this can be applied to each and every field inside your table so that a proper history or a proper data is being generated. Second method, we call it as the bivariate method. Here you can use this cross-tabulation graphs and covariance methods to identify the relationship that exists between the different data. You know what is cross-tabulation, right? You are crossing the values between two different values. You are swapping it. Okay. So I'm not getting into the deeper part of it. Maybe after CAE 1 is done, I can go with the practical example of all these techniques. Okay. As of now, these are the two methods that plays a major role in your exploratory data analysis. The final step is modeling the product itself. Okay, whatever you are working with, how to model this entire data? As I told you, I didn't get a proper thing because I was doing it in a hurry. Okay, I have to spend much more time. See here, I didn't get a much more time. I didn't select the data properly also. This is the original solution I got. With this, I should have got this outlier data, whichever is not essential for this application. No, it should be here. Okay, so that model is this last step. Okay, how to do this is we can use some mathematical techniques, okay, maybe a matrix correlation techniques, transformation techniques you can use to produce a better model. Okay, so this gets the maximum intelligence out of that particular data. What else is the purpose of this is it identifies the relationship that exists between these fields along with the particular data. Okay, so this is the flow of this data analytics. Any queries, guys?
No, sir.
Yeah, did you get an overview? What is data analytics?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, yes, okay. Sir.
Yeah, right. What do you have for the next star?
Next star.